Crosswind landings require you to counter the wind drift which pushes you off your flight path in a circuit, particularly on final approach. You can account for this wind drift on finals using either the side slip approach or the crab approach. First up, we're going to cover the side slip approach. To fly a side slip approach, you first need to check for wind drift on final. Then you counter that wind drift by lowering your upwind wing. And then to prevent the aircraft turning, you apply opposite rudder. And then you maintain this side slip down towards the airfield where you flare and touch down on the upwind wheel. Then once you touch down, you apply aileron into the wind to prevent the upwind wing rising. That's the procedure for a side slip approach. So we'll go in game and check that out, and then after that we'll look at a crabbing approach. Coming in on finals and using a side slip approach, you're going to have wind blowing from left to right at 20 knots. So to do the side slip, we want to lower our left wing to counter the wind drift, and then we'll apply right rudder to keep the aircraft straight and pointed towards the runway. For these crosswind approaches, I avoid using more than half the amount of flaps. And since we're coming in with a side slip, we're going to have a slightly higher approach speed as well. Now as we're coming in, we're going to have lots of little adjustments between the aileron and the rudder to help keep ourselves straight. And ideally, as you're getting closer on approach, try and aim for the upwind side of the runway to land on. Doing this will help you avoid getting blown off the runway. Getting ready to flare, so we want to make sure we land on the upwind wheel. And then once we touch down, we can start applying brakes and left aileron to prevent the upwind wing rising. As you can see for the side slip, we've applied left aileron, but we're countering that with right rudder, and this keeps us heading straight towards the runway. So as you're coming in, remember that you want to be aiming for the upwind side of the runway, and that you want to touch down on the upwind wheel. And then as you touch down, just apply left aileron to keep the upwind wing from rising, and slow down to taxi. Now let's look at the crab approach. To perform a crab, you want to roll on a heading into the wind with the wings level, and this forms a crab angle that counters the wind drift and keeps you on runway centerline. You can transition into a side slip at any point during the final, but usually pilots will do the transition when they're ready to flare and touchdown. And at that point, it's the same as landing in a side slip approach. Now that we've gone over the crab approach, we'll look at it in game. Coming in for another crosswind landing using the crab approach, we know the wind is blowing from left to right. So this means we'll point our nose to the left into the wind to counter the drift and keep ourselves going straight towards the runway. Now the heading you're using to counter the wind drift won't always be remaining static. There'll be minor adjustments you'll need to make so you can adjust your landing position on the runway. The critical part about the crab approach is being able to transition into the side slip very smoothly. It's up to you when you make that transition, but it's easiest just to do it above the runway. So we're getting closer and preparing the transition. Apply right rudder and left aileron at the same time. And we touch down on the upwind wheel, apply brakes, and then do left aileron to keep the upwind wing from rising. As you can see in the external view, the crab angle is pretty evident, so you can either maintain it or adjust it so you can land on the upwind side of the runway. The real key is being able to make a smooth transition from the crab to the side slip. As you see, right rudder, left aileron, touching down on the upwind wheel, and we're safely on the ground. I hope you enjoyed the video on side slip and crab approaches. If you did enjoy it and you want to see more, hit the red subscribe button in the top left corner.